Hey, what's going on YouTube? Glad to see you here once again. Now, today's video is pretty much our build in the Corsair 500D case, but we did something really cool. We actually tested it, did a full build in it, and made a time-lapse video showing Anthony putting the entire system together, which is actually pretty cool. So this particular system, I want to state right off the bat, is about $1,500. I have all the fans on it right now, turned up to full blast, so you guys can hear even while we're filming how loud it is. So if you were building the system, you're wondering, well, how loud are those LL fans, eh? Well, this is how loud they are. They're really, really nice fans, too. They're complete RGB, and even when you turn them up on full blast, they work pretty doggone well. If this was inside of my room with me, I wouldn't be complaining, going, oh my God, turn those fans down. And you guys know how some systems are when you have the fans turned full blast. You can't even barely hear yourself think unless you're wearing headphones. So this is the full-on. Now, this particular system is based on an AMD build. So it's pretty much AMD as much as possible. No, I didn't use an AMD SSD or AMD memory, but the CPU, the motherboard, all the basically heart of the motherboard is all an AMD build. It's a 2600X. The system looks really, really nice. The attention to detail in the build and everything is really, really cool. I think you folks are really gonna like it. But with that said though, let's jump in, let's check out the parts. Then let's check out the time-lapse video, check out those scores, and at the end of the day, well, even though the system costs $1,500, there's still a lot of room that you guys can do for upgrading and making this system even better than it is today. So let's jump right in. The Corsair Obsidian 500D is a mid-tower case that features smoke tempered glass on both the front and back, and you can open these very easily. You just pop them open and close them. They all work off magnetic, so it's really effortless to open and close the windows. It also features aluminum trim. The entire inside of the case is really nice and smooth, and as you guys will see later on in the video, doing cable management in this particular case is very easy as well. The power supply is completely covered by a shroud. There's plenty of room inside of it for different radiators, different fans. It's got just enough room in it to fit pretty much like the maximum size parts that you can get. And if you want to use an aftermarket cooler between the motherboard and the window, there's just enough room, like I said, to put in just about any part out there. For the motherboard, I wanted something that was really nice, but yet something that wasn't going to be in the $300 and $400 range, making this system just completely excessively priced. So I chose the ASUS Prime X470 Pro. This is an AMD Ryzen 2 board, AM4 technology. You can use DDR4, all that good stuff. It overclocks pretty nicely as well. All in all, for $155, this is a very solid motherboard, and I've had no issues with it whatsoever. The AMD Ryzen 5 2600X processor, it actually came with its own Wraith cooler, but I decided that, you know, I really didn't want to use the Wraith cooler. I want to use something just a little bit better. Even though those work really nice, I'm not knocking it, I wanted something that just had a little bit more oomph. Now, this particular processor is about $225 right now, but if you're looking for a really high-end AMD processor, one that has 6 cores and 12 threads, it's completely unlocked. It has a maximum frequency boost of 4.2 gigahertz. All in all, this is a really, really super powerful CPU that can be used for gaming, for editing, all kinds of stuff. And the price really isn't that bad. And on Amazon, it's actually one of Amazon's best-selling processors and an Amazon Choice product. Like I said, I wanted to have a cooler that was a little bit better than the stock cooler. How much better, I really don't know, but I just wanted to experiment. So I went with the Scythe Fuma. Now this is the revision B of this particular cooler. It's about $50. It features a dual tower design. This helps increase the heat dissipation, and it actually does it more effectively by helping dissipate that heat all the way from your CPU and then blowing it out with those fans. Now the Scythe, it came with two of its own fans, but we modified that design. We took the fan out of the middle, we placed that on the outside, and in the middle, we put a really nice LL Corsair fan featuring RGB technology. This helps dissipate and get the air away from that hot CPU. The memory we use in this build is the Corsair Vengeance LPX 8GB kit. Now you guys all know that memory's pretty expensive right now, and this particular kit's about $126. I know, don't hit me, I know it's really expensive for memory, but you guys know that right now memory really is at a premium. This is DDR4 3200. When you go inside of your BIOS, this particular motherboard, you just set it to that speed and you're good to go. The AMD motherboard doesn't have XMP profiles directly, but when you set it, it just works at that speed automatically, making it really simple to set up. Inside of this system, you guys will see there are a lot of fans. And so we chose the Commander Pro from Corsair to control these fans, and it integrates really nice in this particular case. The only caveat about this particular product is it is $65, but it makes managing all the cables, hooking everything up and controlling it a breeze. And this can all be done through the Windows environment as well. So if you're inside your Windows environment, you want to change some stuff, you just click some buttons and hey, you can change anything you want to the speeds like you want. Most of the fans inside of the system are the Corsair LL Series LL120 RGB fans. Now, these are 120 millimeter dual light loop RGB fans. They're really, really quiet. They can come in a three pack and you can get three of these for about $80. I have to tell you folks though, these fans even turn to full blast, as you guys can see in the video, are really quiet. So if you're looking for something that not only looks good, can move a lot of air and not produce a lot of noise, these fans are really nice. I know they cost a few dollars more, but I think they're worth it. And controlling all of these fans and everything is done through the Corsair Link software, which you guys can download and install into your system really simply. The power supply we use in this build is the Seasonic Prime AirTouch 850 Gold power supply. Now, this is a fully modular power supply. And one thing really nice about this particular power supply is on the back, there's a button where you can change the fan speed. So if you're doing a lot of gaming and you feel your system's getting hot, you can adjust the fan speeds all the way up to pretty much loud. And this particular fans on the power supply get even louder than those LL fans when it's turned on full blast. So you know that that power supply is getting really, really cooled. It's about $160, has a great warranty, great fan. It also has a cell phone tester and a 12-year warranty, which is really killer. The boot drive in this system is something really, really unbelievably cheap. It's an SSD, 120 gigabyte SSD, that's only $25. And if you want to get a 250 gigabyte model, it's only $42. Now this is the Inland Professional 120 gigabyte, SATA 3, 6 gigabyte a second, 2.5 internal solid state drive. It's a mouthful, right? 120 gigabyte SSD, pretty fast speeds, a decent warranty, and a price that's only, hey, $25. For the storage drive and for playing all the games, I chose the Seagate 2TB Barracuda drive. Now these particular drives, 7200 RPM drives, they're very fast, they're reliable. They're not quite as fast as the FireCudas, which are kind of a combination of an SSD and a hard drive, but they're really well known. It's a solid drive and it's under $60, currently $57.99 and another Amazon Choice product. Video card prices have been skyrocketing up and down. When we did this build, we chose the Gigabyte Aorus Radeon RX 580 card. This is an 8 gigabyte card. It's currently under $300, so it's a really nice price card. It still plays games good. Obviously, if you're gonna get the latest video cards from them, they're gonna play games a little bit better, but hey, the 580 is nothing to snuff at, especially the 8 gigabyte version. Okay, so those are all the parts, and the parts themselves are about $1,400. The reason I said $1,500 is that some people out there get really picky if I don't include the Windows software, and to get Windows 10 Pro is about $100, making the system about $1,500. Like usual though, you can make some different part changes inside of the system. You could sacrifice some or get something different. There's all kinds of different parts out there. But with that said though, let's jump in and let's check out Anthony putting this system together in a time-lapse video and seeing how all of this comes from a bunch of separate parts on a table into the nice system you see here before you. So first off, after we've gotten all of our parts together, we know exactly what we're going to put inside of the build. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to mount the CPU onto the motherboard. This is a pretty easy process. We'll be having a video later on showing you guys exactly how to do this in more slow motion so you guys can take advantage of that. But after that, it's just installing the CPU on the motherboard, then installing the cooler, and then after all that stuff is done, it's now ready to be stuck inside the system. So let's move over and let's start preparing the system for the build. First up, we're gonna entirely gut the Obsidian 500D. And the reason that we're gonna do this is once you gut the entire system out, it makes it much easier and cleaner to start putting all the parts back inside of it. This only takes a few minutes. And as you guys can see, once everything's outside of the system, it's really easy to get back into and put those parts back. First, we're going to install all of the front intake fans. These are all really nice Corsair fans and they all feature RGB. In fact, all of the fans used in this build today are all RGB fans, so you get lots of lighting options. Mm-hmm. Before we put the rest of the fans in, we're gonna install the power supply, figure out where all its different wiring goes, all the different connections. You guys can see the power install installs in the 500D under the back and the bottom, and it also has a shroud that completely covers it. So once the power supply is installed, you can't see it whatsoever. The 500D has ample room in the back of the case to install your SSDs and your hard drives. And here you guys can see that we're mounting the SSD back there, and there's also plenty of room back there to work with. So when you do your cable management later on in the build, you'll see that there's just enough room in there for you to get everything in there nice and snug and still get the cable management looking good. Earlier we showed you guys installing the CPU onto the motherboard, installing the heatsink, and then installing the memory and all that stuff, but now we have to install all those parts inside of the system. Now installing the motherboard inside of the case isn't really all that hard, especially when you have a nice case like this. All the offsets that are on the back of the case make installing the motherboard really simple. And then once you put the motherboard inside of there, then comes the real kind of tricky part of connecting everything on it and making sure at the end that all that stuff works that you've just connected. It's a lot of wiring, believe me. Now starts all of the cable stuff. And like I said, the cable management is where I think our builds really do shine. We have excellent cable management due to Mr. Anthony. He's really good at this. He's been doing it a long time. He pays attention to detail. He takes his time. Right now, he's hooking up the Corsair Commander to all the lights and all that stuff. The Corsair Commander, it actually controls all the different lights inside the system. We didn't use the onboard one that came with the case. We actually used the Commander. We just think that one gives more options all around, so that's the one that we installed. Now earlier, I told you guys about installing the hard drives in the back of the case and how there was ample room inside of the case for doing all that cable management. As you guys can see, as he meticulously goes through and does all this stuff, all of the cable management starts to come to fruition. In this video, I know it seems really, really fast, and like he put this whole computer together in about 5 minutes, but this is actually a couple of hours of time just condensed down so you guys don't get totally bored watching hour-long videos. If you'd really like to see a video that's not, you know, in a time lapse like this, and you'd like to see the full event of it, let us know and we can make a video and we can do that. It'd just be a very, very long video because this does take quite a bit of time to do properly. Next up, we're going to install the video card, make sure it's all in there, make sure it's not sagging. Also, you want to make sure when you're installing the power supply and getting all that cable management stuff that you definitely have the right leads for your video card. So if you need 2 8-pins or you need 2 6-pins or an 8 and a 6, you got to make sure that you leave those connections open. And if you also plan on doing Crossfire or SLI later down the line, you want to make sure you leave all those lines out and available to you so that you don't have to try to dig it out once the system's built. Because trust me, getting to the power supply and doing all that once the system's completely built can be a real pain in the butt. So when you're doing your build, make sure you know what you're going to do in the future. If you don't plan on doing SLI, you don't plan on doing Crossfire, then obviously that doesn't mean anything to you, and just make sure you have the wiring out for one video card. Finishing up the cable management is where it gets really meticulous, because you got to make sure that you wrap everything together, you got to lock it down, you got to make sure that it all fits in the backpack there, that it doesn't look all messy, and that the airflow through your system is completely clear, which means there's nothing just lying around in there, you know, causing airflow restriction. I know some people say, oh, it really doesn't matter, but I feel having the cleanest airflow path possible is the absolute best thing that you can have in your system. After the cable management's done, it's just a matter of putting all the parts back onto the outside of the case and getting it ready to put Windows on. You have to admit, this system looks really badass. It's a very well put together system. It's nice, clean lines. It's very beautiful. But hey, looks are just one thing. How does the system perform? Well, let's check it out. We'll be right back. One thing kind of interesting you guys will notice is that the CPU maximum temperature was 71 Celsius and the video card was 72 Celsius. So there wasn't very much of a difference between the AMD CPU and the AMD GPU, which is kind of pretty interesting. The rest of the scores are really nice. You guys can see if you want to install a better video card, you want to get yourself a Vega 56 or a Vega 64, obviously you could do that. And that's one of the nice things about this system is that you can upgrade it and change into whatever you want because life is about options. All right, tech fans, so there you have it, our build inside of the Corsair Obsidian 500D case. And you gotta admit, she sure looks absolutely nice. All of the scores in this particular system are really right on par with what they should be. Like I said earlier in the video, you have the options of changing out the video card. The CPU, I don't really think there's any reason to really upgrade the CPU right now. I mean, 2700X is a little bit higher, but this is really, really close, and you guys can see it runs really well. So if you're a streamer, somebody who plays games, all of that type of stuff, obviously this is gonna be a really nice system. And I have to say that even though the system's air-cooled, only getting 71 Celsius as the maximum temperature when the system's under full load is still pretty cool. So the CPU cooler is working really nice. Previously, we had used a Wraith cooler, and believe me, it was a little bit hotter than this. So paying that extra $50, I think in the end is worth it to get that, you know, aftermarket CPU cooler that just works that wee bit better. And putting that center fan in between them gives you just more airflow, which helps dissipate that heat, helping to keep that CPU running really cool. Video cards, hey, they are what they are. Prices have been so crazy lately, you never know where they're gonna be really high or really low. But if you wanna add just like another $150 to this or $200, you can get all the way up to a Vega 56, making this system about $1,600, probably $1,700 at the max. But then you get all this really cool stuff. Like I said, RGB fans are really easily controlled inside by the Link software. The Commander Pro, it makes hooking all this stuff up together. You guys saw the cable management, how that all went together. Using the right parts, even sometimes, you know, when the parts might cost a few ducats more, sometimes make the difference between a system that's totally cool and really awesome looking, or a system that has a bunch of cables lagging around or just looking messy. You guys can see, this bad boy does not have any messy cables whatsoever on it anywhere. It runs nice, it performs nice, it's quiet. If you like this particular build, hey, you can do one for yourself or choose whatever parts you want to exchange in and out to make it your personal build. I'm Elric, like usual. We will have a link below to all of these different parts. If you're not subbed to the channel, I ask, hey, please sub. And if you don't have notifications turned on, hey, make sure you do that as well. Also, if you'd really like to support the channel, we have Patreon going on as well, where you can chip in a few bucks and just help Tekken Tomorrow keep Tekken. Peace.